All right, now that we've got our little box, let's do some drawings. I'm going to do an assembly view, which is an isometric view with some balloons. So let's get started. We're going to start in the Techdraw workbench, and then we're going to come up here to the Insert Default Page icon and click on that, and that'll create a new drawing page for us to draw on. It's A4 and there's a default title block. You can change both of those, the size and the title block, later on if you so choose. But for now, we're going to put something on it. Now I want an isometric view, so I'll click on that, get that isometric. It's important because the view that you see here is what's going to be put onto the drawing. So if it's in some, I don't know, bizarre orientation like that, that's what you're going to see in your drawing if you click on when you insert the view. So we want to be sure we have it the way that we want it to be. So we'll highlight the project box that tells the system that this is the stuff we want to put in the drawing. And then we will click here, Insert a View. And we come back to the drawing, you can see there's a new view. The view has a frame around it, and that allows you to grab it and drag it all over the place and put it where you want. And you can turn that frame off by right-clicking and just selecting Toggle Frames. So I'll leave that on for the moment. Now, actually I'll turn it off. I want to add some detail to this. So I want to put some balloon references on there and a parts list. So to do the balloon references, I'll click on the part that I want to reference, click on the balloon, and tell it where I want the balloon to be. So I want that balloon to be about there somewhere. So that's item number one. Now the lid, click on there and tell it I want it to be about there, and for the box I'll put it about there somewhere. Alright, looks pretty good. Now we've got the balloons there, we can just grab those and, you know, put them however we want them to look. So there we go. Now it's time to do a parts list. You can do that a couple of ways. One way to do that is to use an annotation, which is just a piece of text somewhere on the drawing. And you could edit that by coming down here to the properties, click on default text, click on this, these three dots here, and then you can edit that. And you could add screw, for example, what was that, lid? Oh, perhaps lid. There we go. And you could do that. And then we can put that down here somewhere. Turn frames off. And here's a very basic parts list. But parts lists usually have part numbers and quantities and such. So we probably can do a bit better than, well, I think we can do a bit better than that. So instead of using an annotation, I'm going to use a spreadsheet. So to do that, I'm going to come up here and go to the spreadsheet workbench and then click over here to create a new spreadsheet. Now if I double click that, I can now edit it. So I can say we have item number, quantity, part number, and description. That's not how it's spelled. That's a bit better. Alrighty, so item one was the screw. So we had four of those. I'll give it a number. You'd use the manufacturer's part number there, I guess. That is a screw, countersunk, M3 by 10. Item number two was the lid. There's one of those, and I'll call that, give that a part number. Let's see, BX-01-01, and that's the lid. And item number three was the box itself. There's one of those, BX-01-02. That's the box. Now, you need to take a note of the cells here. Because that's, well, it's important. I'll show you why. So when we come back to the page here, now we want to insert that spreadsheet in there. We'll go to the Techdraw workbench again, highlight that spreadsheet, and then we'll come up here and click on Insert View to a Spreadsheet. If we come back to the page, you can see that there's the view of the spreadsheet, but it's only got two rows and two columns. So if we come down here to the properties, we can see it's only displaying from A1 to B2. But if I change that to D4, we get all of the rows. If I make it say, I don't know, D5, probably get a blank row at the bottom. I might do that. All right. So there's a fairly professional looking drawing. But we need to put some details in the title block. So the title block itself, actually before I do that, let's just quickly have a look at the page itself. Now the properties of this page, you can change the projection from third to first angle. Or if you come up here to the template, come down here, click on template, you can change the size of the drawing. So let's change that to an A3. There we go, because the other drawings are probably going to be A3 as well. So I'll just move that around. Okay, so let's give this a title. We'll call it Project Rocks. Okay, and I'll call that Assembly, Author, Me. Creation date, I don't know, April Fool's Day, why not? So you just go and fill in these details. Scale, that's not to scale. Weight, probably 50 grams. You can put those in or not, it doesn't really matter. Part number, or drawing number, BX-01. And this is one of maybe four sheets. So I can put that a couple of ways. I can do that, or I can go off. There you go, that might work. All right, so there's our drawing. Hope you enjoyed this short tutorial, and hope you watch the next one. So thank you very much for watching.